for parental guidance. Thank God for special message from the district. I wish we could just be singing the whole day. We wish to can only be singing. Because singing is nice. Singing is good. Sabbath is very small. Just a very short day. But to wrap up is a simple sermon. Something that we are familiar with. Something that we are used to. The message that we are well acquainted with. Now this red. The red. Red. Now this red had a business on the other side of the railway. Now on the railway, only the train is allowed to move there. But unfortunately, the red had a special business on the other side of the railway. Because there was a cheese on the other side of the railway. Now the red has to go attend the business. But the train as well was coming. As the red was going to attend the business, the train was approaching. Then this red, unfortunately, when it was attempting to get the cheese, the train get closer. And when the train get closer, it doesn't have a dead brick. When the train is coming, and you are on the railway, who unto you? We must start writing your obituary. Now this red forget that this is not its railway. Now the red was going this direction. The train was going this direction. Now the red and the train collided. Such that the red had to change the direction that it was going to. And it turned into the direction of the train. Now the business of the red and the direction of the red had to be changed towards the direction of the train. I am not talking about an ordinary train. I am talking about grace. When a sinner is on the business of getting a cheese on the other side, and the train called Jesus, the train called grace, is approaching on the other side, the direction of the sinner. When he collides with the train, he has to change direction and head towards the direction of the train. That is grace. Now this message is simple. We are reading from the book of God, the book of Daniel. I love the book of Daniel because we are the remnant church. Daniel chapter 5 is pregnant with powerful stuff. I will read only 4 verses, then we will wrap up. The Bible says in verse 1 of chapter 5, the Bible read thus, and Belshazzar the king made a great feast to 1,000 of his lords, and drank wine before the 1,000. Verse 2, the Bible says Belshazzar, whilst he tasted the wine, commanded to bring the golden and silver vessels which his father Nebuchadnezzar has taken out of the temple which was in Jerusalem, that the king and his princes, his wife and his concubines might drink therein. Then they brought the golden vessels that were taken out of the temple of the house of God which was taken at Jerusalem, and the king and his princes, his wife and his concubines drank in them. But verse 4 is pregnant with powerful stuff. The Bible read thus, in verse 4, they drank wine. Verse 4, it says they drank wine. Tell your neighbor that it's fine to throw a party. It's fine to throw a party. The Bible says they drank wine and praised the gods of gold. Now here comes the problem. After they've drank wine, they praised the gods of gold. Now the Bible says of gold and of silver, of brass, of iron, of wood, and of stone. Book of Daniel chapter 5 is a powerful book. It's a people in
in a foreign country.
It's
of people in a foreign land. The chapter 5, you will never understand it if we don't start from chapter 1. In chapter 1, they are in Babylon. They are taken out of Jerusalem. They are in Babylon, but they are not Babylonians. Are we together there? We are in a foreign land, but we are not of this world. They are in Babylon, but not of Babylon. Being in Babylon doesn't make you a Babylonian. The Bible says they were in Babylon. Now there were changes around them. Hence the Bible says, and Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself by eating from the table of the children. I want to say to the youth choir, do not defile yourself. Have a purpose. I want to say to the church without a purpose, that church is literally dead. Daniel purposed in his heart. In chapter 1, everything has changed. The environment has changed. When there are changes around you, they are constant with God. When you are sick, it doesn't change God. It changes you. But it is business as usual to God. It doesn't surprise him. Chapter 1 of Daniel, you don't understand it, because the chapter 1 of Daniel is Revelation chapter 18. Am I talking to the remnant church? Daniel chapter 1 is Revelation chapter 18. They are in a foreign land, but they are not of that world. Hence Revelation 18 says, come out of thee, come out of her, my people. Don't partake in her fornication, lest you also drink from the vine of her judgment. Come out of her, my people. The problem with us, we know too much that we need to come out of Babylon. But the problem is, we need to come out of Babylon, but with Babylon. Yes, we want to come out of it, but we want to come with it. We are bringing it into the house of God. The Bible says, get out of it. Leave it and come here. Chapter 2 is actually a statue of different features. But we are hearing about a kingdom which stays forever, which is going to fill the whole world. Now, the chapter 2 of Daniel is Revelation chapter 21. The Bible says, and I saw the new heaven and new earth, for the former heaven and earth has passed away. Then I saw a voice, I heard a voice coming from the throne of God, saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with his people. It shall be to them they are God, and they shall be his people in a foreign land. We are waiting the kingdom which shall stand forever. In chapter 3, we are introduced that though you argue with God, you will never win. We see Nebuchadnezzar arguing with God, because in chapter 2 he saw different features. Chapter 3, he make a statue, pure gold only, trying to argue with God. You will never win. In fact, in the Bible says, is God talking? Even in my foolishness, I will still be wiser than you. When you are wise and I am stupid, I will still be wiser than you. In chapter 4, there is a beast in you. There is a beast in you. Now, chapter 3 of Daniel is Revelation chapter 14. Fear God and worship him, for the hour of his judgment has come. Only worship he who has created, not that which has been created. Chapter 14, in chapter 3 of Daniel. In chapter 4, there is a beast in you. If you nature this beast, if you water this beast, you will change into an animal. You will be a dog, a donkey, or a cow. And the Bible says, Nebuchadnezzar, one of the good days, he was walking in his balcony. He says, look at the town, look at the city that I, Nebuchadnezzar, have built myself. God always humbles those who exalt themselves. humble them. And then the Bible says, immediately he was humbled, he turned into a donkey, he ate grass. Be careful. Daniel chapter 4 is Revelation chapter 2 and 3. The church of Laodicea, you think because you know Daniel and Revelation too much, you think you have it all, you think you are you have worked. Oh, how naked you are, Laodicea, and in fact you are disgusting, and I am about to spit you out of my mouth. In chapter 5 we are introduced to a king called Belshazzar. Belshazzar was born by Nebuchadnezzar. He didn't learn the lesson that his father was taught by God. Belshazzar got advantage that he is born from royalty. You need to pause a moment. Let me step on your toes a bit. You know, people who are born in the church, people who are born from church or in the church, they are rotten. Are we together there? Belshazzar was spoiled and rotten because he is coming from the throne. Now, because I am born in the church, I think I own the church. Spoiled and rotten Belshazzar. The Bible says he throws a party. Throwing a party is nice. The Bible says Belshazzar throws a party. It is fine, tell your neighbor, it is fine to throw a party. When throwing a party, the Bible says he invited the well-known people. He invited the concubines. He invited the women. When that was not enough, when he was trying to show off to the women, the Bible says he went and took the silver, the vessels of silver which his father has taken from the temple. He invited everyone, but didn't invite the master. And the Lord didn't have problem with that until he went into the temple, take the vessels which were supposed to be sacrificed to God. He used it to drink wine, and the Bible says he sacrificed to his gods. I want to say to you, be careful how you throw parties. Don't play with the holy things, because God attends parties. My God attend parties. Even when not invited, he attend parties. Be careful, youth choir. When you are going up and down singing, when you are camping here, don't play with holy things. God will visit you, and he will deal with you in a way that you will never forget. The Bible says he visited Belshazzar because of taking holy things. Don't you know that your bodies are the temple of God? Be careful how you handle. Be careful how you conduct yourself, because that body is not yours. He is holy. Be careful how you handle holy things, because God will come. And the Bible says when he was throwing, drinking, and the women were passing by. If you want to take a man down, just bring a woman. A woman pass by. Be careful or something. Pass by. The woman, the man will tell you all the secrets. The Bible says when he wanted to show off the woman, he took the holy vessels. But to cut a long story short, the Bible says there was a program. And they were following the program. Then there was an uninvited guest. He attended the party because people are playing with the holy things. Daniel chapter 5, in fact, is Revelation chapter 22. He who is unjust, let him be unjust still. He who is holy, let him be holy still. Then the Bible says, when the man, or when this God, when God visited, the Bible says he didn't write on a paper as a program. He wrote on the wall for everyone to know. It's not for an MC only. The whole world should see that the Master is here. Though not invited, he is able to invite himself. He writes his program on the wall. Menemene, Utekel Pharisee. And the Bible says, Nebuchadnezzar Belshazzar didn't understand the writing. Immediately he saw that. The Bible says, his spinal cord was broken. don't play with holy things and walk away with it. The Bible says his final cord was broken. You don't understand this until you have studied medicine. When your spinal cord is broken, wherever you are, however you are, it's a toilet. Now
Belshazzar,
when he was showing off to the woman, the Bible says the master shows up, and when the master shows up, he shows off. Then he wanted to show off. Let's see, Belshazzar was better between you and me. And the Bible says, you don't see God and walk away from him. The Bible says Belshazzar couldn't handle only the handwriting, not the face of God, the handwriting. Because of the handwriting, he had to actually rush to the ablution block on himself. Right there where there was a party, it turned into a sandwich. When the Lord visited, be careful how you play with holy things. Your body is a temple of God. Be careful how you handle it, because God will visit and he will write. Be careful. It might not be a toilet, but it might be something else. But thank God for Jesus, because when they were there, I don't understand the reading. I love this. Because I visited military. When I visited military, they are playing. When they are shooting, they are those who are accurate enough. They shoot straight at the target. And they will say, this is the man. Now when we are fighting, or when we are actually growing up as boys, when you do what others cannot do, they will upload at you and say, this is the man in Babylon. The Bible says, when there was no one to interpret, now the grandmother to Belshazzar has to walk in and say, why worry when you can pray? Why worry? Because there is a man in your kingdom. This man, the Spirit of God, is upon. We are looking for youth. We are looking for ladies. We are looking for boys in the youth choir, which in them is the Spirit of God. I want to say to someone, when things are not coming, there is a man. There is a man.